Hello. So in this video, we would be creating a Kafka instance. So we would be creating an VM instance first and install Kafka on top of it. So let's go and see how we can do it. So I will be creating an VM instance on Google Cloud. So let me give it some name. The name should be in small case only. And I'm interested in E2. Okay, that's fine. I think I will go with standard memory. And in case of boot disk, I will change that boot disk from operating system Debian and I will select Ubuntu. 20.404 LTS is okay. So it is for long-term support. So this is as well fine. Let me give it some 60 GB. We won't need that much. You can reduce if you need so. So this will give us a pricing summary. Okay, this is $1, $6 monthly, but we won't use it for that long. Rest of the properties we can keep at as it is without changing anything. And let me go and hit create. So once you create the VM instance, you can see the status here once it is up and running. Till the time, what we also need to do is we need to fire some commands to set up our instance. So I will walk you through that. Apart from that, we also need to have this external IP, set up this external IP as in static IP, so that whenever we restart our Kafka instance, this IP doesn't get changed. And whenever we will be using from our external resources connecting to this Kafka server, this IP should remain same. So in order to do that, let me IP address. So let's go to view network detail and see if we have any options. So if you see on the left hand side, we have IP addresses. Okay, and I have created this earlier, so you don't have to worry about it. But in case you need to select, so let's see what is our IP address. So let me go back here and in compute engine, I could see this is our IP address 34.125.151.28. Okay, let's see how we can make this static. Okay, so let me go to network details, then go back to IP address here. So this is now right now our external address. In order to make it static IP address, we need to take IP. The name should be in lowercase. Then hit on reserve. So this will reserve our IP address as static IP. So in case we change anything on that server, it doesn't matter. Or even if we restart the server, the IP address won't get changed. So let me go back to compute engine and then now the status is running. So in order to connect, I can click here and open in browser window. So this is the first step. Now we should be able to connect to the VM. So the initial first time will take a little bit of time, but going forward it would be very smooth. So let's wait for a couple of more seconds till the time it gets started, and once it gets started we will see how we can install Kafka on it. But before installing Kafka, there are prerequisite some commands we need to execute. Like for example, as this is a server we are starting for the first time, we need to update the package list, like to upgrade an installation from the repository. So let me update it. So this will update the repositories. The next important thing is we need to install JDK. To install JDK, that is the primary prerequisite to run Apache Kafka. So once we done that, then only we can install Kafka. So let's wait for this to get finished. Yeah, all the packages are now up to date. So let me install JDK now. Installing JDK now. Let me give my, as this will take 810 MB additional disk space. So we are waiting for headers, so it's executing. So once this get executes, let's take a Java version, like which version we have installed. Yeah, now the installation is finished. So let's check which is Java version which was installed. So yeah, now the Java is successfully installed. We can see Java version returning something. So now let's go and install wget as well, which we would need to download files from the web. So that is basically Kafka we need to download. So now wget is installed. So let me create one more directory inside this. So let me also name it like YouTube Kafka something. Now let me go inside that directory and let me download the Kafka instance. This I will give as part of this video as well. So once we download this, we need to extract the contents of out of this Kafka package. So it is in compressed format. We need to decompress it. So to decompress it, we would use tar. So now that Kafka is also downloaded, let me uncompress it using tar command. Okay, so this will uncompress it. Yeah, now we can see we have, let me do ls and check if everything is going well. Okay, so now we have this directory installed. Let me set it up as Kafka home so that I don't have to give entire path each time when I will execute. So I'm setting it up as Kafka home. Okay, the first thing which we need to do is we need to use a command on Google Cloud which will enable the firewall rules to collect allow the TCP port 9092 to connect. And apart from it, we can connect it from external different IP addresses. So we need to connect from multiple IP addresses from an external site, not on Google Cloud. So this command will help us to. So this command will help us to enable the firewall rules. So coming back to this Google Cloud homepage, now what we need to do is we need to execute a command which will enable the firewall rules. In order to do this, there are multiple options. We can go from this UI and add as well. But what I would prefer is using this Cloud Shell. So once we have this Cloud Shell running, we can directly fire the command. So we don't have to do it manually. So let's give it a couple of seconds more to get it started and then we can execute. Now that our cloud instance is running, let me execute the command. So the command is like this. So we are using gcloud compute firewall rules and we are allowing the ports. So right now we are allowing all the ports to execute because at this moment we are not sure which ports we will be using because we would be creating multiple broker instances and giving different port numbers. Even also we are not sure which from where we would be connecting to this Kafka server, Databricks, Google Cloud or Google Colab. So we can connect from multiple sources. So I'm allowing everything, but this is not recommended in production or an real environment. So let me create this. We need to authorize it. Once we authorize, it will be creating a firewall command. And it has activated. So